Claude Monet. François Thibault Cisson, from Le Temps. The newspaper? I wrote to you, Monsieur Monet.
At least you got my name right. That's a start.
I was here on time. I've been right round the garden looking for you.
Yeah, you look a little red. Almost vermilion. Journalists. They all want to know me now. So many interviews and articles. It wasn't always like that. We saw the world afresh, but for a long time the world didn't seem to understand us.
I'm on my own here!
The Impressionists, they called us. We were painters of water, of light, of colour. We were of our own time, yet beyond it.
We begin at 8 in the morning with drawing from life. Each week, our model adopts a classic pose, and with constant attention, you will start to understand the skills of the old master. I will help you when I come in twice a week to correct your attempts.
When do we paint, Mr. Clare?
A beginner first learns drawing, and then how to arrange colours on the palette.
Come here to paint.
I've been here for weeks. I haven't even seen a paintbrush.
You'll get used to it.
Tell me, Monsieur Monet, whose classic pose is our model taking this week?
Titian.
Renoir.
Titian, Monsieur Clair.
It's a bit dusty in here, sir.
My studio is out there.
You always paint outside.
I invented it. They thought we were mad.
Who do you mean by we?
That crowd.
I met Renoir and Basile at Glaire's Academy. Friends I would never lose sight of.
My father doesn't believe that being an artist is a proper job. So the agreement is that I attend Glaire's Academy, Oh, he cuts me off.
Well, doesn't your family realise you're going to be world famous?
Yeah, we all are, Basil.
They want me to take over the family grocery by the sea.
You mean you've sacrificed being a grocer? Won't you miss it?
I miss the sea.
You'll miss the vegetables.
Now, I'd have spent my life in Le Havre as a caricaturist if it hadn't been for the sea. Makes my head spin.
And this is what makes my head spin. I don't know if I would have become an artist if God hadn't created the female breast.
It's a hobby for me. I've yet to sit my medical exams.
I'm still painting flowers on porcelain vases. I should have been a tailor like my father.
Is that me? My nose isn't half that big.
What? It's a beautiful nose.
Oh, thank you.
So you're a laundress?
Since I was 10.
Oh, such beautiful hands.
I used to go to the beach instead of school. I could never stick to the rules even then. There was something so vivid, something, once I found it, that set the course of the rest of my life.
So, your inspiration came from nature, not from other artists?
The inspiration's no good on its own. It's like sugar. To make the best of it, I had to put it with something else.
I like mine with my chocolate in the morning.
Yeah, or plums, even tomatoes.
Sometimes you need a bit of a jolt. Well, who gave you a jolt?
Different people, different times. All dead now.
Who kept you going, then, when you first arrived in Paris?
Renoir and Basile. And someone else, who I didn't get to know for a while. I knew his work. Everything we thought of as new started with him.
When I looked at Manet's work, one world ended and another began. The women in his paintings were unconventional. His great muse was Victorine Meurent.
Look at me, Victorine. Straight at me. Turn your face towards me and look at me.
You're not going to paint me looking straight out the canvas, are you?
I'm a god. There are cherubs circling my head. This is Paris in 1862. Only one of those is true.
This is Paris and it's 1862.
This is how we live now.
Is this what growing up in a house of Puritans has done to you?
Most probably.
What did you think about my picture?
I retouched it.
I asked your opinion.
My opinion was that I needed retouching.
Would you retouch a digger? No, because it'd be an insult.
You're just starting out.
Oh, and you're not master, are you?
I'm master of your time while you're in my studio.
Can I rest a moment?
No.
My back is stiff.
Look at me, Victorine. Look at my face.
You can remember what I look like for a few minutes.
I can't. I can only paint what I see.
The peaches aren't going to last, but that's peaches for you.
Suzanne was his anchor. They married around this time.
It's 3 o'clock. Has he given you any lunch?
No.
Well, then he shouldn't blame you if you eat his props. He does the same to me when I sit for him. You must be cold.